Hi, it's almost September 2023 and Home Assistant 2023.9 will be released on the first Wednesday of the month. This time there are some interesting user interface and template changes. And there are more things to mention. Let's dive into it. Summer is almost over and a fresh Home Assistant release is almost available. This release has some interesting UI changes for the climate dialog and tile cards. Next to that, you can start creating template sensors using the UI, and there are more changes that might be of interest to you. One thing I noticed is that there's nothing new to report about the voice functionality this time around, which seems a bit odd since this is the year of voice after all. Be aware that this video is based on the beta version of 2023.9, so it might be that some functionalities will not make the final release. The climate, humidifier and water heating dialog has got quite a big overhaul. The climate dialog has gotten a ring that shows what the target temperature is. The little dot shows the current temperature, and when you move the ring beyond the dot, you will see that it will turn to orange and starts heating. The current temperature is also visible above the ring. Next to dragging the ring, you can also click on the plus and minus signs to set the target temperature. And there are buttons to set the mode and preset. With all these changes, the interface of the climate dialog is touch, keyboard and mouse friendly. When you control an air conditioner with the thermostat card, it shows the same ring, but this time the ring has multiple options depending on the modes that your air conditioning provides. The ring changes color for each mode. In my case, the current temperature is the same as the target temperature. I'm not sure if this is a bug in the beta or that this is a limitation of my air conditioning. Please let me know in the comments what your experience is with your air conditioning. When you choose to heat, the ring can be dragged from left to right and turns orange. When you choose to cool, the ring can be dragged from right to left and turns blue. Next to this, there are buttons for mode, preset, fan mode and swing mode. The tile card has new features for climate devices, covers, lights and the lawnmower. You can select climate modes and the target temperature for climate devices now, so that you can quickly switch between the modes that your heater or air conditioner provides. And you can easily change the target temperature on the card itself without having to go into the dialog of the thermostat card. For light entities, you can enable the color temperature feature so that you can quickly change the color temperature for a light or a light group on the card now. For covers, you can enable the cover tilt position and the cover position feature now as well. I do not own a lawnmower robot myself, so I couldn't test the lawnmower features, but there should be some lawnmower features for the tile card now as well. Talking about the lawnmower, a new entity component for the lawnmower is added to this release as well. You can start and pause the lawnmower and you can send the lawnmower back to its dock. Only MQTT is supported for now, but more integrations will come in the future. In this release, a new helper feature is added to the group helpers. You can now preview the value of a group helper in the group helper dialog. Let's say you want to know the median temperature for two rooms like the front and the back of the office. You can create a group, select the front and back office temperatures, and select median as the type. You will see the results straight into the dialog. This helps a lot when you're setting up groups and want to check if you set up the correct type and selected the correct devices. This next new feature of this release can be a big one for people who like to create template sensors but do not like to code a lot using a text editor. You can now create template sensors from the UI. You can choose to create a sensor or a binary sensor. In my example, I will create a sensor that calculates the net power usage in my house by subtracting the value of my solar panels from the value of the power that I'm currently using. You can enter the template code in the dialog and select the unit of measurement, device class and state class as well. This makes it much more easy to create templates. At the moment, the template state edit field is a bit small, so I hope there will be an option added to expand that field so that editing will become a bit more clear. And now the next change is a change that I personally do not like at all. One of my biggest automations makes use of the weather forecast attributes in the weather integration. These attributes are going to be removed from the weather integration in 6 months from now. So I have to refactor my sprinkler automation that makes use of these attributes. Instead of the attributes, a new service is introduced in this release that gets the forecast. It's called weather.getForecast and will respond with the forecast. So in 6 months, you cannot create a template sensor anymore to retrieve the forecast, but you need to create an automation that gets the weather forecast and does the magic to show the forecast values or calculate the total precipitation, for example. The guys from Home Assistant do see that this change is a bit too impactful and will make it easier in the next upcoming releases, so let's wait and see how this evolves. The onboarding flow of Home Assistant has changed in this new release. It's easier for new users to start using Home Assistant now. One of the new things is that you can change the language during onboarding now. In the previous release, you could already search for an address, and now you can select all the tracking options as well. Furthermore, you do not have to configure all the found devices right at the beginning, but you can just click Finish and start configuring all your devices in a later stage. Next to these new functionalities, there are more changes. The whole list of changes will be added to this page, but for now, the following noteworthy changes are known to me. Local Bluetooth got faster. You can now set colors for energy graphs. You can sort the options of input select. When you change the password, you can log out of all instances directly now. And the file upload, for instance the person's picture, got a new design. CO2 signal is renamed to electricity maps. This release also contains some new integrations that you can find in this list. For now, there are new integrations for Comlet Simple Home, Lawnmower, Schlager, Trafikverkehr Camera, Vodafone Station and Yardian in this release. As always, this video is created based on the beta release of Home Assistant 2023.9, so the functionalities in the final release might slightly differ from what's in the beta. The final release of Home Assistant 2023.9 will be released on the first Wednesday of September. Make sure you read the breaking changes to prevent you from running into any trouble after you've updated to this version. Thanks for watching, and if you like what I do, please consider sponsoring me so that I can keep this channel alive. The links to Patreon, Ko-fi and becoming a member of my channel are in the description below. I'd like to thank all the wonderful people on this list who became my sponsors. You play a vital role in keeping this channel alive. Thanks. And please do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to make the channel grow. I will see you soon in my next video. Bye bye. CO2.